than cows and grow stronger where man faints, and of a waste of worldly fortunes sends the radiance of its quenchless fidelity like a star. Being a full-time mother is one of the highest salaried jobs in any field, since the payment is pure love. The phrase working mother is redundant. If you have a mom, there is nowhere you are likely to go where a prayer has not already been, if you have a mother, because mothers pray and pray. We want to appreciate one lady that was born a day like today, Tracy Minor. We want to ask her to stand up so that we can, so that we can sing happy birthday. We'll start when she stands. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. If you are born a day like today, Mother's Day, please would you stand up also? We are to appreciate you today. Bless you. Whoa! Yes! Now, you that are close to those people, ask them their first name. Then when you sing, you will whisper that name to them, okay? Please ask them. Will this be Naitabu Nani? And Akwambia? Neona wengine namjua Alice. Aya, to idea how happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, dear Alice. Happy birthday to you.
That's cool. How many people are celebrating an anniversary that you got married on this day? Are you not a wonderful person also? Anybody who remembers when they got married? You know, some of us have a problem. It went so fast that Monday came and some of us think we got married on Monday. Anyway, don't you worry. You got married. Amen. There is a song that I want you to help me sing while seated like that, if you can. But if you can't, you'll stand. It will help me share what I'm sharing today. Remember we started the book of Jude? And we started by saying Jude is writing to us. He wanted to write to us concerning the issue of Christianity, our salvation. But in the middle of his writing, he changed so that he can warn us, he can help us. And we saw in the first place, he wants to help us so that we don't defect from our faith. And he said, the reason is because the enemy wants to hit you and he doesn't care who you are. He cares what you are. And that's why we say, I am saved, I am blessed. We talked about those things that the devil wants to hit you on. We also say the devil also wants to hit what you have. It is not what you're thinking about, it is what you have. So the devil wants what you have. And we saw what we have among the many things is that I'm secure. In my house, I have never said I am the man of the house. Because I wonder, which other man is in that house? So I never told my children, do you know I'm your father? Because I look around and there is no other father except me. I'm secure. Even in this church, I've never stopped Chikuku and tell him, Chikuku, you don't know I'm the bishop here. I've never, because I look around and I'm secure. There is no, I'm not fighting with anybody. Even when I'm driving the car, I don't stop and roll my windows to tell the people passing by, where would you eat it? I don't. I'm secure. We saw among many things that is so precious that the devil wants to hit that out. And I pray that God can make us secure even in our homes. Then last Sunday, we moved a step further and we said, one of the things that the devil would like you is to scare you. He will try as much as he can to scare you so that you doubt God. And we said this in nutshell again, trying to pick what Samson said, because I think somebody was better. Because he said this, all what God wants us to do, because we know him, we take all our requests to the known God. We just deal with the known God so that the known God can handle the unknown future. Because the enemy wants to scare you for the future. Do you know, yesterday I met someone and we talked. He's a member of ACCNS, which is Alice's home church. And then as we talked, he told me, I'm coming from Kenyona. He told me that he had... Then I said, you know, Kenyona, I used to love to come to Kenyona, but now, and I mentioned his younger brother, I said, if I go to visit Waititu, I might not meet him. He might come home at 11 at night. But I miss the place. But then I told him why he goes many times. It's because of the age that he's in. You know, there is a certain age. Mazishi ya kwenu. Nasima uitwe. Kuna wengine hapa bwana wabariki. Hamuitangu. Lakini itafika pahali. Mazishi ya kijiji. Lazima kuulizwe kama message imefikia bishop. Has the message gotten to the bishop? That's why he told me, anakimbia ile ile wrong with you. And I told him, it's your age. And then he told me it is true, because when he was in high school and after he started working, funerals would happen in Kenyona and he would be told after, oh, Papa so and so died. Ah, he moved. But nowadays he has to know. There are certain things that you will have to be be taught. And that's why I want you to help me sing this song, then I'll bring three other points and then we'll be done. Amen. Tell your neighbor, we'll be done. Amen. The book of Jude, a wonderful book. The song that we used to sing in the 70s used to go something like this. I shall not
be moved, just like a tree that's planted by the water side. I shall not be moved.
Let's try it again as you sit down. Don't stand yet. Because we want to see whether you can pick it up. Once you pick it up, we stand and sing it together.
I shall not be moved.
Like, and another one. All right, we'll sing with those oldies. Then we oldies, we'll sing now. Now you can stand. Hallelujah. Okay.
I shall not be moved.
Just like a tree that's planted by the water side.
video was taken when you are just standing like that. Let's read together Jude. We read in verse 8 to 16. Jude will read verse 8 to 16. If someone can put it to us, whatever translation you put, we'll read. Amen. See your 8 to 10. I had one say, oh, already. To some 8 to 10. Oh, Santa. In the very same way, these dreamers pollute their own bodies, reject authority, and slander celestial beings. Verse 9. But even the archangel Michael, when he was disputing with the devil about the body of Moses, did not dare to bring a slanderous accusation against him, but said, "The Lord rebuke you." Verse 10. Yet these men speak abusively against whatever they do not understand, and what things they do not understand by instinct, like unreasoning animals. These are the very things that destroy them. 11. Woe to them! They have taken the way of Cain. They have rushed for profit into Balaam's error. They have been destroyed in Korah's rebellion. 12. These men are blemished at your love feast, eating with you without the slightest quarrel. Shepherds who feed only themselves. They are clouds without rain, blown along by the wind, out on trees without fruit, and uprooted twice dead. They are white waves of the sea, fuming up their shame, wandering stars for whom blackest darkness has been reserved forever. Enoch, the seventh from Adam, prophesied about this man, seeing the Lord is coming with thousand upon thousand of his holy ones, to judge everyone and to convict all the ungodly of the ungodly acts they have done in the ungodly way, and of all the harsh words ungodly sinners have spoken against him. The last verse. These men are gladness and fault finders. They follow their own evil desires. They boast about themselves and flatter others for their own advantage. Father, speak to us this morning. And dear Father, if it pleases you to speak to us in a language we can understand, we'll be forever grateful. We honor you, dear Father, and we give you praise. For this we ask in Jesus' name, and everybody say amen.
Amen.
Let's sit down now, sit with a smile, if you have any. And because some of you forget your smile every other Sunday, you can ask your neighbor, please, nichote kidogo. Nichote tu kidogo. I don't know whether you have moved from one house to another. Now, everybody who has moved would agree with me that there are some things that we normally see when we are moving we don't like. Some dirt which has always been in a corner in a chair somewhere. Once you remove it, then you discover your house help has always made you very happy, but it is around where the carpet is. You've also discovered, if you have moved, that there are some things actually you ask yourself, na hii nimekuwa nikiwekea nani? Some are your clothes, and others would be other things that ata stove ile ilibika kitambo ikatoboka umeweka chini kuna gas mingine nayo sijui umeweka wapi. And when you are moving, is when you discover, na hii nimekuwa nikiwekea nani? Na OLX awanunua hiyo imetoboka. So when you're moving, you find the clutter, the dirt, and everything that you have around. And it is good for us to know that we need always to know that where we stand, if you're not careful, we will gather a lot of clutter, a lot of dirt. There will be a lot of things that will happen around us if we are not careful. Somebody said from where I come from that if you don't travel a lot, you think your mom is the best cook. But just travel a little, then you discover your neighbors, they know how to cook fish. When I was a little boy, there was a neighbor that nilikuwa nikikatalia kwao. Paka ugali ipikwe na tupewe samaki. Alikuwa mtu wa kutoka Ingo. Nikishauma hiyo samaki na kimbia huko. Na ilikuwa poa sana. I still remember. That was hardly three. Ninasikia tena linaitwa. Na ninaomba wasikaribie nyumba kwa sababu akitana kwa ile nyumba nitaitika. Waitane wakiwa mbali, kibali. And then wakishapakua nikichapa anasema asante sana. Wait, that what? Mnaniangalia namna gani? Na wengine hapa najua chapo ikipikwa utoki mpaka saa ile utapatua kipande ukishaonja wale ambao ni walikaiwe. Chapo ilikuwa ikidukia tunaingia mahali unangoja mpaka upewe ya kwanza. Chauma ndio unapangua kwa sababu kuna gedheri hata ikiwa ina wataka kuongea sana. Ndugu kanaweza tu kwa gazeti. Nilikuwa na haraka kidogo. Kwa sababu hiyo hata kwenu iko. Na by the way, gedheri ya mwaka ule nilipozaliwa ile miaka, kila nyumba ilikuwa haina maharagwe. Kwa mahindi tu. Sijui maskini ilikuwa imetoka wapi. Kila nyumba ukienda hiyo gedheri ni white. Na kama imepikwa na waru, imekimwa na waru, ni mahindi ya white na waru ya white. Kwa hivyo ilikuwa white stuff, wonderful white thing that we used to enjoy so much. So if you don't travel, sometimes you think you are the only person that knows a lot. And a lot of our cultic groups is because they think they are the only ones. You know, kind of, you think you're the only one. One time some group came to this country and they were very interesting as they said, we are the church. The church. Kenya has only one church and that church is us. And they quoted a few scriptures and they carried on the day. And actually they blamed everybody. They pointed fingers at all the others because they thought themselves were better. But as the years have gone, they have also looked around and they have a lot of clutter. Yani, vumbi, nyingi. Which needs to be cleansed, and I pray that Deliverance Church Zimmerman and Deliverance Church International will not pride themselves in any one way, but they should always look and say, if it was not the Lord, if it was not the Lord, if it was not the Lord, in the book of Romans 12 and verse number 12 verse 1 and 2, Paul is trying to tell the Romans church, what you need is a renewal of your mind. You need your mind to be renewed so your focus becomes different. And if you don't do that, your mind will become so packed with the view that it will not be able to think right or to focus well. So Jude was talking to people who were in danger of being deceived by some other people called Gnostics. And here in our text, it describes how to recognize false teachers in our own day and time. Because the whole idea of Jude is so that you and I can know how can I escape some of these things that come to us. The theme of our sharing is staying spiritually straight. And our topic today is how to recognize spiritual deceivers. How to recognize spiritual deceivers. Have you ever been deceived? Anybody here who has ever been deceived? Huh? Yes. No, Ropa, nataka kukuita hapa. Have you ever been deceived? Or do you want to tell us how you are deceived? Anybody courageous enough? Hey, how many people have been deceived? Would you like to come to tell us how you are deceived? No? Sangura, but don't preach. You know Sangura can preach. Eh? Just statement, ulikuwa deceived ulipokuwa msoma ama ni hapa Nairobi?
Bwana asifiwe sana. Nikitafuta job siku ya kwanza, nikitapeliwa, nikapelekwa mpaka kwa ofisi, nikapewa fomu nijaze, nikalipa shilingi 500 na nikaishia. The following day nikakutana na huyo ndugu hapa Zima Manamba. Kuniona nikaona natoka vio, nikajua hapa nitapeliwa.
Deceived. One man, he's not my friend, but this story I had in town. This man wanted to buy a house. And he saw a house actually advertised in the newspaper. Umoja. A house in Umoja. And it was written, the office, where the office was. It was in Gill House. Fourth floor. And the guy went to Gill House, went to fourth floor, went to that office and negotiated. He was told the house in Umoja actually is 1.2. But if you have 800 cash, I'll give it to you. Just think. 1.2, 800 cash. You are saving 400. So the guy said, yeah, let's go and see it. So the guy went and saw it. There was a tenant. And he was happy, he spoke with the tenant very well. You know when you're going to be the tenant, you speak with your tenant well. Oh, he knew my head. He liked it. So he went back to town and paid the 800. 800. Then he thought, before he brings his wife, let him go back there again. Now he tells the tenant that he has to go to the house. So he went back to Moja and told the guy that he had met there, I'm your new landlord. And the guy wonders, new landlord? You let me get into Kukufa, Mekufa. And the guy, the tenant is asking, is the other landlord dead? No, he says, no, but he has sold it. So he says, wait a minute. Thank God for mobile phones. Send your name, thank God for mobile phones. Oh. He just removed his kamongoni and called. Hello? Hapa kuna mtu, amenunua nyumba yako. Ati, mwambia simame hapa nikuje. So the owner came. Ati, umenunua nini nyumba yako? Hii, siuzi? Umepewa logbook, umepewa title, eh? Lakini yangu siuzi. Utaleta title yako. Na hii yangu. Tuende kwa nini. Akasema, kabla sijafanya hivyo, hebu nirudi kwa ile ofisi. Kwanza ninaitua. Akarudi Gill House. Akapanda fourth floor. Kukuta ofisi imefungwa. Akaambia watchman, hawa wameenda wapi? Watchman akamwambia, hiyo ofisi haijakuwa na watu. Hapana, walikuwa hapa asubuhi. Akamwambia hakujakuwa watu. Akafunguliwa. Hakukuwa meza, hakukuwa kiti, hakukuwa kitu. Kwa hivyo, yangu ni kusema watchman, na hao jamaa walikuwa. The guy sat down. And because men don't cry, they cry inside. He discovered he had been deceived. Many times when you're being deceived, the first thing that happens is that you don't want to tell anybody. Amen? It's a secret. Actual fact, you think, I will surprise my spouse at Aniona. Taikia nyumbani na gari mpya. KCC. Impaka hapo. Atanigundua. Sa hiyo, ile ulikuwa nayo, ushaliwa na mtapeli fulani, alikwambia wewe umewini. Last week, ulikuwa nimewini 100. Nina. Airtel. Kaza nikambiwa, upigie fulani, umewini. See, I know the response. Because one day, amen, I was deceived. I had to run very fast and, because that's what it was this year. Uwe jamani nilipatia kila kitu hata pili. Uwe alikuwa amesema pahali anatoa. When I called my daughter, akanichekelea, akaniambia, Dad, surely. Si alikuwa akikuitisha namba ya nini ya Equity. See, the pesa zako anakuibia saa hii. Anyway, by the grace of God, we were able to. So I'm talking to people that have been deceived. Amen. People that have been deceived are in the church today. And I want to speak to those people that have been deceived so that we can make sure next time we don't get deceived at all by anybody. So Jude is trying to tell us, and he lists three identification marks that will help us spot the deceivers before they deceive us. Number one, listen to their wicked speech. Wicked speech. You know, people that come to us, actual fact, they have a language. Call them, they'll talk to you. They should talk to you. This one was calling me the other day, he said, don't he started by saying, and don't give your pin to anyone. Keep it. But you know, they are also telling you to talk to someone, eh? Then I remember the trick. Listen to their speech. Their speech normally, where I come from, they say these are people you can give their your child to them, and you know what toto hawanunuliwi kwa soko. You know, ameongea vizuri, unaweza mpatia. Ah, chukua huyu. Nataka mwingine. Acha huyu mwingine tukupatie. Ameongea vizuri kabisa. So their language, and you know somebody said this, if the deal, think twice, if the deal is so good, sit back and think two times. Ya kwanza think, alafu mwambie naenda kulala. Then when you wake up in the morning, think again. Don't allow yourself to because people have a way of catching an emergency. Anataka kuwa emergency yake ni yako. Jude, verse 8 to 10. In the very same way, these dreamers pollute their own bodies. They reject authority and slander celestial beings. But even the archangel Michael, when he was disputing with the devil about the body of Moses, did not dare to bring slanderous accusation against him, the devil. He said, the Lord rebuke you. Yet these men speak abusively against whatever they do not understand, and what things they do understand by instinct, like unreasoning animals. These are the very things that they destroy them. In other words, these people, they will have nothing good about anybody or anything. All of a sudden, you know, we in the 70s, early 70s, it used to be a man that had a negative word for every denomination. For example, he would stand up and say salvation, amen. He would call it starvation, amen. AIC, Akamba Ignored Church. You know, he had a word for, negative word, for anybody else. One way is to know someone is a deceiver, is that what they don't know, they will use the language to discredit that which they don't know. Even people who have no idea about the infilling of the Spirit of God, he fills us with speaking tongues. People who have no idea will talk ill about speaking in tongues. I remember one person telling me, oh, Brother Jimmy, hii kitu ni kumutu zinakopi tu, nakopi mashamba, na maduka, na kadhalika. Siwende ukopi tu wanze. Sadi kamambia, yako ulikopi maduka na mashamba, eh? Yangu siku kopi, yangu ni original, nilipewa na mwenyewe. You see, because if they don't have it, they will have a negative thing about anything. They dreamers, and they pollute. These people have no respect of authority. Most of the denominations, the cultic denominations we have in this country, when they stand, they start like everybody else is on error, but they are the only one who is on the truth. But look at them 10, 20 years down the road. They discover the truth is only one. And the guy who is the truth is Jesus. He is the way, the truth, and the life, and nothing else. Anything else, whether baptisms, you see, for you that are coming to our class of the post-encounter and the school of leaders, we'll teach you. There are some things that are secondary. They are secondary. For example, laying on hands, a baptism, whether it is of water or anything, those are secondary. But there are things that we need to pursue. Amen. Jude describes the speech of false teachers as slanderous and abusive. He also gives an example of this through a story about the body of Moses. The point of this is to show that if Michael, the archangel, was careful in the way he spoke to the wicked devil and Satan, then who are we? Who are we to say something about Holy God? Who are we? And they will speak about that Holy God that we trust in. In actual fact, although there was contention and fighting, Michael the archangel discovered, no, the guy who rebukes you is not me, it is the Lord. And I think we need to get to that point where my struggle with anybody, I reach to a place I discover the struggle, the fight, the battle is not mine, belongs to the Lord, and these people are getting faith into it, therefore, let the Lord do the rebuking. And for sure, Satan knew. When he was mentioned, the Lord rebuke you, Satan had no ground. May the Lord give you that anointing and grace to know that there are some things that you don't need to argue with anybody. Let the Spirit of the Lord, let God Almighty rebuke the enemies that you have. But honor the Lord rebuke you. In other words, he left it up to God and let the Lord take care of the situation. That's a lesson for us today. False teachers don't care what they say about anyone or anything. They are like the people David described in Psalm 73, verse 9. They verbally attack heaven, but down here they own the people around on earth. Those people are like that. I've heard of one who so that people can receive him. Before he starts sharing, he says, Niko na salamu. Nipewa salamu saa hii na Ibrahim. Tukua na ee, kanabia ni msalimia. Mumesalimika? Nye ni salamu Ibrahim. And people go, wow, the guy speaks with Abraham. How many of you have ever gotten into trouble because of something you said? What we say gets us into trouble because it is based on the truth. Notice the three reasons that I will back that one point. Number one is because whatever they say is based on their opinions. Whose report am I going to believe? I'm going to believe the report of the Lord. How many of you have ever gotten in trouble because you expressed your opinion about something? You know, a man goes to the doctor for a checkup because he isn't feeling well. And after the physical examination and the battery of blood tests and x-rays, he asks the doctor about his situation. And the doctor replies, you are very sick. You might not even live longer than 3 or 4 months. Then the man in despair, yet with a glimpse of hope, he tells the doctor, if you don't mind, I would like to have a second opinion. And the doctor says, okay. There are several different words used for the word dream in the Bible. For instance, sometimes God spoke to the prophets through their dreams, but this is not the kind of word Jude uses here to describe those false teachers. Instead, it is a word that describes a confused state of mind, abnormal imagination. False teachers are not shaped up by the truth, but rather by their own ideas. Their own opinions. They live in a dream world. They actually think that what they teach is the truth, but in actuality, they are opinions from their beliefs. You know, I said again about Kanyari here the other day. I said, when he was asked by the interviewer in Church in Life, you know, he said, me, I don't preach about heaven. I don't preach about salvation. In other words, he has nothing good about going to heaven. All what he wants to tell us, Nikide uko nacho 310. Tutume 310. Hiyo itakuwa ni sawa sana. Proverbs 18 verse 2, fools have no desire to learn. They would much rather give their own opinions. Secondly, it is based on their ignorance. Jude says that false teachers also speak against things they don't understand. Do you know how you can tell when a person is ignorant? It is when they open their mouth. Because when you open your mouth, then we can know. Even a person who doesn't say anything looks wise. Will Rogers once said, everyone is ignorant about something only a different subject. In other words, sometimes if you want to know how ignorant a person is, let them open. And some of us, oh God, help me and have mercy upon us. We like opening our mouth and every time people see how ignorant we are. Especially men. Oh, you are a bee. Oh, DNA. Oh, God. Oh, wiper. And some of the things we are saying, we have no clue, no idea. But we have to impress others. Kwa sababu wanaume lazima tuimpressane bwana. Actually, in fact, you would ask him to accept from reliable sources. But you can know somebody so ignorant when they open their mouth. So ignorant. Jude says that false teachers also speak against things they don't understand. Do you know how you can tell when a person is ignorant? It is when they open their mouth. When they open their mouth. A little illustration here. One Saturday morning, a hunter woke up ready to go to bag his first deer on the hunting season. He walks into the kitchen to get a cup of coffee, and to his surprise, he finds his wife dressed and ready to go and hunt. So he asks, the wife, "What are you doing?" His wife smiles and says, "I'm going hunting with you." Even though he had some reservation, he reluctantly decides to take her along. When they arrive at the hunting site, the husband sets his wife up safely in the tree stand and tells her, "If you see a deer, take care for him, and I will come running back as soon as I hear the shot." He then walks away with a smile on his face, knowing that his wife couldn't bag or hit an elephant, let alone a small deer. But about 10 minutes pass when he hears gunshots coming from his wife's direction. Quickly, he starts going back, running towards her. And as he gets closer, he hears her screaming, "Get away from a deer!" So he runs even faster, and again he hears her yell, "Get away from my deer!" Followed by another gunshot. Now, with each sight of his wife, he is surprised to see a cowboy with his hands high in the air. The cowboy obviously distraught, saying, "Okay, lady, okay, you can have your deer. Just let me get my shadow of it. I know none of you got the job there. I missed all of you." But what the wife was calling a deer, the farasi ya huyo jamaa, wamepiga risasi kanguka chini. Sasa huyo jamaa ako chini. "Wacha, wacha pia yangu." The guy say, "No, take it. Let me take my sandals. Nitoe ile vitu nilikuwa nimeweka kwa farasi." Can ignorance get you into trouble? Yes, it can. False teachers say things that they shouldn't say because of their ignorance. Ephesians 4:18, "Their minds are in dark, and they are stubborn and ignorant, and have missed out on the life that comes from God." The other reason on that point number one is based on their feelings. Feelings. The word instinct in verse number 10. Jude describes false teachers as animals. Animals do the things they do not because they know the difference between right and wrong, but rather because of their instincts. That has to do with a person's feeling or desires. Have your feelings ever influenced something you have said or the way you said it? Of course they have. And that's why there are so many verses in the Bible about being careful what you say. Psalms 141:3 say, "Help me to guard my words whenever I say something." James 3:6, "The tongue is like a spark. It is an evil power that dirties the rest of the body and sets a person's entire life on fire with the flames that come from hell itself." 1 Peter 3:10, "If you want a happy, good life," amen, Read that with me. If you want a happy, good life, keep control of your tongue and guard your lips from telling lies. Look at your neighbor, atakama kuamini mwambie wewe. If you want to have a happy, good life, keep control of your tongue and guard your lips from telling lies. I shall not
be moved. I shall not be moved, just like that tree that's planted by the water side.
Our Heavenly Father, the Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, this morning we pray that you would help us to learn how to pick deceivers among us. And Lord God, we know the use language, and therefore we need to be attentive as we listen, so that we can pick areas and ways that they want to put us down. And Lord God, as the week starts tomorrow, Lord God, our prayer, like Judas prayed for us, is that we'll be careful. Indeed, we'll take care, even of the things that we hear and the things that we say. In the mighty name of Jesus. I realize